He's back. Yep, just as the sun goes down, eh? Spot on. Beautiful. Nature's TV.
Morning, Rick Turner again from IT Bushcraft Adventure. This morning I'm going to knock up a survival boat. So nothing fancy, it's just going to be a quick boat to survive. So I need some meat, some protein, whatever, so I need to knock a survival boat. Ideally, if I was making a long-term boat, I'd be using something like yew, a decent wood like yew, which is ideal. But I'm going to use this off-cut. This is out of an old shelter of mine, so it's seasoned. It's been in a shelter for a couple of years. But I'm not going to do anything fancy. I'm just going to rattle up a survival boat as fast as I can. Main objective is not to nick the outside. I'm going to leave the bark on, because that's going to be the bit that's going to be stretching. So I don't want to nick any of the fibres and split. The inside's the bit that compresses, but it doesn't matter about that. I'm going to cut the inside away, so we'll get on with it. Knock us about.
Starting to take shape.
Welcome back. I've been away for a few days, well, 3 or 4 days. I've been in Scotland doing a bit of climbing and everything. So, started my bar, left it, I've just come back to it now. Got a little bit on it today. So, what I've got an arrow, but at the minute that's slightly bent. We're going to have to straighten this arrow up. So the best way of doing that is to heat it up in the centre. Done with this arrow as well. I've used what I've got on me really, so not many pine trees around here, so I would have traditionally I would have used pine pitch, passing an arrow point on, maybe something made out of flint, a horn, an arrow head, and sinew to tie it on, and then pine pitch to finish it off. Same with the flights. You use sinew and pine pitch. What I've done is I've used what's available in my bag. So I had a little bit of fishing line, yeah, and a bit of string. Well, unfortunately, my battery went dead on my GoPro. Using the phone. But as you can see, by using that process, straightening my arrow. So this is the arrow I've made, quick survival arrow. Like I say, I've got some flights on the end. Now these are pheasant feathers that I found knocking about. You're probably better using something big, something like a goose, a swan, something like that, something with quite decent big feathers, but these will do the job. It's unbelievable the difference feathers make. Right, in order to string this bow, I've just used what's in my bag, so I've just got a bit of string, a bit of paracord, something like that. End of the day, it's a survival bow. So if I needed, I could string it with my shoelaces if I wanted. Yeah, I could string it with something that I have, a string in the hood of a jacket or the draw cord. Yeah, it's about using what you can. So what I'm going to do, put a loop. So I'll put a loop on the bottom. Yep. That's the bottom. So that's that strung. Then for the top, what I'm going to do, I'm going to lean it on my foot. Yep. Put my outside leg through. Yep. And then I can bend it over. Put the top one. Yep. Have a look. So that's for our row. Great bit of kit. Took me about an hour and a half to make it. Definitely hunt small game with this, birds, rabbits, fish, all sorts of stuff. Right, so it's bye for now from me and Billy. Hopefully see you again soon. Cheers.